Next news. This is out of Moscow in Russia. Muslims in Moscow say they lack space for Friday prayers. There are four mosques in the Russian capital, Moscow, but the growing Muslim population struggles to find a place to pray. Some Muslims complain the issues of new mosques have been politicized. Russian news coverage about Islam is largely focused on terrorist activity in the majority Muslim North Caucasus region. So, yeah, I don't think that a lot of people realize this, because in Russia, you think of how everything has to be exactly the way Putin wants it to be. But, you know, they're anti-LGBT, they're anti-religion pretty much in the most part. But Islam has been thriving in Russia. I don't know if you want to say thriving, but it's been in Russia for hundreds of years. It's been there, and it's been growing, and they actually have places in the city where they can get halal meat and other you know, things that are generalized around their culture. So this is accessible to them in Russia. The problem is that Islam has actually grown so much there that between the four mosques that exist, it's so crowded, people are having to, you know, cram into tiny spaces. People are having to wait to get into the buildings. I think that what this is, and this article didn't exactly, because it's not really an article, it's an interview, so it didn't exactly say what the problem is with building more mosques, but I can imagine that they're having a hard time doing that.
Who builds these mosques? The government? Because, who are you complaining to?
I didn't know enough about it, and I wish I did. I you know, researched, I tried to figure this stuff out, but... Mm. Aside from the fact that knowing this has been around for hundreds of years, it could have been, you know, back then.
But who are they complaining to? Like, correct me if I'm wrong, is anybody stopping them from, if they have a private land and if they have the money, you could build a mosque? Are they complaining because the government is not giving them a mosque? Because that's a dumb complaint. I mean, as a Muslim, you don't really need a mosque. It's not like you can't pray, you can't do your five prayers if you don't have a mosque. You can pray anywhere. You can pray at home by yourself. Yeah. It's not a necessity to have a mosque.
Well, what they're saying that society around them isn't ready to give them more mosques. There's the group Muslims in Moscow, and they have the four mosques, and they said they can easily deal with two more, but that they think there's a problem with getting more mosques because the society isn't ready to give them more.
That seems like...
And that the government is listening to residents who don't want to see more mosques near their homes.
Well, that seems like they're asking not for equal, they're asking for privileges. Like, this is, you know, this not equal rights. Like, people don't like your religion and you're complaining about that. Well, your religion sucks. Boo fucking who? Like, come on. Like, no, this is, I don't know. I don't think this is I'm trying to be fair here, okay? I don't think that this is a legitimate complaint. What do you think? I mean, maybe we need to... Maybe there's more details to the story that we don't know about.
Maybe there are. I think that what they're saying here overall is that they need more space to pray. Their mosques, the four they have, are packed to the brim. The government is not allowing them to have more mosques because the people and the societies around them don't want more mosques near their homes. I do actually kind of feel for them. I think that, you know, they should have the right to put up more mosques if they need more mosques.
Well, nobody is denying that. I don't think that right is being denied to them. But, I mean, I sympathize with people that don't want a mosque near their home. You know how loud these things they are? The call to prayer is annoying as hell. Like, imagine that five times a day next to your house, right? So if you have your own private land, right? And if you raise money and you could build a mosque, and the government is saying, no, I'm not going to let you build a mosque, but they're allowing, for example, for Christians to build a church, then I guess in that situation, your complaint is legit. Like, what the hell? Why do they get a permit and I don't? But if you don't have the private land, or if you're not raising money to build your own mosque, and you're just sitting back and like, where is our mosque? Instead of you just building it yourself, if that's your complaint, then go fuck yourself. Nobody, the society doesn't owe you a mosque. If you
No,
want
yeah,
a
I do agree.
mosque, just build a fucking mosque. Your own money, with your own private money. The society doesn't owe you anything. If there's, if some other people are getting permits and you're not, then yeah, okay, fine. But that doesn't seem to be the problem here. The problem is, like, yeah, it's your own, you know, if you want something, just go build it yourself. Like, what do you want? Like, you just, I don't understand. Let me see what the top comment is. Sorry, you wanted, Ellie, you wanted to say something?
No, I think that the problem is that they do have to, and again, this is just a transcript of an interview. It didn't really give me much to go on. When I tried to do research about this, it was hard to find anything. But I think that the way things are, and somebody please correct me if we're wrong, the government in Russia does have to approve before anything's built. So whether they had the money or not, it would still be the government. The government would have to give them the A-OK to build it, basically. And what they're trying to say is that Russia focuses constantly in the news that Muslims are terrorists and Muslims are violent, and so people for that reason don't want the mosque.
Well, that's just the fucking news. What do you want them to do next time Muslims don't make a terrorist attack for them not to cover it in the news?
Like, I just wanted to make that point very clear that definitely is their complaint.
Why are you covering this bomb attack? It makes us look bad. I know innocent people died, but we demand you not to cover it because it makes us look bad. What?
Yeah.
Pakistani atheists are saying there are 1.5 million Muslims in Moscow alone. Wow, is that true?
Well, they say that there are 16 million people and that the population is 9% Muslim.
Pakistani atheist also adds that Putin himself opened the largest mosque in Moscow a few years ago during Eid. It's far bigger than anything else in Western Europe. I think that's going to backfire on Putin at some point. Soraya is also saying, if that mosque is on private land, then will they pay tax, or they will bully government in the name of religious faith? I don't know exactly what the tax situation is for.
It was hard for me to get any of that information regards to this story. Yeah. So if anyone does have that information, that'd be helpful.
Yeah, let us know in the comment section. Todd is saying, like Putin said, Muslims need Russia. Russia does not need Muslims. I think Russia actually does now need Muslims, given how much they are. Actually, that's not true. Yeah, Russia is very involved in the Middle East right now, and they really require the support of Muslims in the Middle East to make their plans. So they're buddy-buddies with Iran right now. Caspa is saying, pray in your home and stop bothering everyone else with your religion. Well, I mean, if you could make your own mosque with your own private money, I don't think anybody should be able to stop you. Where else is this? Other people are saying, pray in your own, in your damn homes. Well, I mean, pray in your own private area, and if your mosque is your own private area, that's fine as well, but don't demand it from the rest of the society. If that's something that you're missing, figure out the solution yourself. The society doesn't owe you mosques.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we're doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.